here in the US in the year around 1900, the blackcurrant industry was about as large as today the blackberry industry is. So blackberries are not the most common fruit, but everyone knows what a blackberry is and you can buy them in basically any store. And that's what blackcurrants were like at around the turn of the century in 1900. And then what happened was around 1920 or in the teens, this disease showed up in the US called white pine blister rust. And it's not a disease of currants, but it's a disease of the white pine tree. And at the time, that tree was the main tree for the timber industry in the eastern US. And so the government got a little frantic because the timber industry was like, hey, we have no idea what's going on here. We need your help. And so they sicked all the scientists on it, and it took them a while, but then they figured out that this white pine blister rust, which is completely lethal to white pine trees, doesn't actually go from white pine to white pine. It actually has to go through this intermediary host. So it goes from white pine to blackcurrant or gooseberry or anything in the Ribes genus back to white pine. So if you remove this intermediate host, you break the cycle and you get rid of the disease. And so the solution to that was that the government spent a lot of money and they paid the Civilian Conservation Corps and local groups and farmers to basically eradicate Ribes from North America. So that means that they had a federal ban on growing currants and gooseberries in the US, and they also sent crews around and burned to the ground these farms and understories of woods to get rid of as much Ribes as they could. And so that once that federal ban was in place, that lasted all the way until the 50s, when in Canada they finally bred the first white pine blister rust resistant cultivars. And so now all the cultivars we use to this day are descendants of those original cultivars and are resistant or immune to that disease. So it's kind of a moot point now. And the federal ban was lifted at that point, but still some states in the Northeast have bans, statewide bans on growing black currants that are just relics of this time and they have not changed it. And so the problem is that even though it's legal again to grow currants, in that half a century time span, you went through a generation or two and our cultural knowledge and memory of that fruit basically disappeared. And so now, if you have grandparents of Eastern European descent, they probably know what black currants are. And if you showed them that you had some currants, they would be really excited. But beyond that, that cultural knowledge just really never got passed down. And so in this country, we're kind of fighting against that lack of memory. Even though we have all the machines, the technologies, the recipes, everything to harvest and process and manage these plants really well because they've been doing it in Europe forever, we're just kind of working to build again that cultural knowledge and awareness of this really great fruit.